Good morning, children. Welcome back to our Max class. Let us continue with the chapter Speed Math. Today, we are going to do some more problems on this chapter. Question: A vehicle travels at an average speed of 72 km per hour. How much will it move in 1 second? According to the question, average speed of a vehicle is equal to 72 km per hour. We have to convert it into second. That is, per hour, we have to change it as second. For easy calculation, we will change this kilometer to meter also. We know 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter. So, we can write 72 kilometer as 72 into 1000 meter. Clear? Now, we have to convert 1 hour. We know 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. Okay, and 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. So, how we will write this 1 hour in second? 1 hour is equal to 60 into 60 seconds. So, instead of this hour, we can write 60 into 60 seconds. When we calculate this, zero get cancelled. Okay, then in 2's table, here 2 is a common factor. In 2's table, 10 will go 5 times and 6 will go 3 times. Again, here 3 is a common factor. In 3's table, 72 will go 24 times and 3 will go 1 time. Again, 6 is a common factor. In 6's table, 6 will go 1 time and 24 will go 4 times. So, answer is 4 5's are 20 meter per second. So, average speed of the vehicle is 20 meter per second. In 1 second, it can travel 20 meter. So, we get how much it travel in 1 second. 1 second, it will move 20 meter. So, in 3 second, how much it will move? It will move 3 into 20 meter. That is equal to 60 meter. So, in 3 seconds, it can move 60 meter. In 5 seconds, how much it will move? 5 into 20 meter. That is equal to 100 meter. In 5 seconds, it can move 5 into 20 meter. 20 is the meter that can move per seconds. So, in 5 seconds, it can move 5 into 20 meter. That is equal to 100 meter. Next question. A 180 meter long train takes 9 seconds to pass a vertical pole. What is the average speed of the train in kilometer per hour? According to the question, a 180 meter long train takes 9 seconds to pass a vertical pole. 180 meter long train, that is length of the train is 180 meter, and it takes 9 seconds to pass a vertical pole. Vertical pole means what? You just imagine a post. To pass the vertical pole or to pass the post, the train takes 9 seconds. We have to find average speed of the train in kilometer per hour. Here it is given in meter and second. See, length of the train is same as the distance. Okay, to cover the vertical pole from the front part to the end of the train, the distance is 180 meter. So, the distance we can take it as 180 meter. Therefore, distance is equal to 180 meter. We have to find the average speed of the train in kilometer per hour. So, first of all, before calculating the average speed, let us convert this meter to kilometer and seconds to hour. We know 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter. That is, 1 meter is equal to 1 by 1000 kilometer. So, 180 meter, we can write it as 180 by 1000 kilometer. Clear? Now, coming to the seconds. Change this 9 seconds to hour. We know 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. Okay, then 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. To convert this 1 hour to second, we can write 1 hour is equal to 60 into 60 second. So 1 second, we can write it as 1 by 60 into 60 hours. So this 9 seconds, we can write it as 9 by 60 in 60 seconds. Clear? Now we can calculate the average speed. Average speed is equal to distance divided by time. While substituting the value, we can write, instead of distance, 180 by 1000 divided by 9 by 60 into 60 seconds. When we divide with a fraction, we will change the division into multiplication and take the reciprocal of the second fraction. So this we can write it as 180 by 1000 into 60 into 60 by 9. Calculating, we can cut down the zeros. The zero get cancelled. The zero and the zero get cancelled. Now, in this, 9 is a common factor. 9 stable, 9 will go one time and 18 will go two times. Now, 2 6 are 12. 12 into 6, 72. So, average speed is 72 kilometer per hour. Next question. A car goes an average speed of 36 km per hour for 15 minutes and 60 km per hour for the next 15 minutes. How much distance did it cover? According to the question, there are two cases, for the first 15 minute travel and for the second 15 minute travel. For the first 15 minute travel, car goes at an average speed of 36 km per hour, and for the second 15 minute, car goes at 60 km per hour. We have to find how much distance it covered. Okay, here one thing you have to note down is that in both the cases, the speed is given as 36 km per hour and 60 km per hour. That means in 1 hour, it will cover 36 km. Here in 1 hour, it cover 60 km. But the time is given as minute. So first of all, you have to convert this minute into hour. We know 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. So 1 minute we can write it as 1 by 60 hours. So this 15 minute we can write it as 15 by 60 hours. This is equal to 15 by 60 hour. 1 minute is 1 by 60 hours. So 15 minutes is 15 by 60 hours. Now we can find the distance covered. In both the cases, speed and time is given, so we can calculate the distance. Distance is equal to speed into time. While substituting, we get 36 into 15 by 60. When we calculate, we get 9 kilometer. So in first 15 minute, distance covered is 9 kilometer. In second 15 minute, distance is equal to speed into time. That is equal to 60 into 50 by 60. That is equal to 15 kilometer. So we can write distance covered is equal to 9 plus 15 kilometer. That is equal to 24 kilometer.
Next question. Ramu and Salim travel to Thiruvananthapuram from the same place, each in his own car. Ramu did the onward journey at an average speed of 120 km per hour and the return at 50 km per hour. Salim did both trips at 60 km per hour. Who made the total journey in less time?
According to the question, Ramu and Salim traveled to Thiruvananthapuram from the same place, each in his own car. Ramu did the onward journey to Thiruvananthapuram at an average speed of 120 km and return at 50 km per hour. Selim did both the trip at 60 km per hour. We have to find who made the total journey in less time. So we have to find the time taken by Ramu as well as the time taken by Selim. But here, to find the time taken, we need distance. Distance is not given. We know distance doesn't matter. Whatever be the distance, the average speeds remains the same. So let us take the distance as 600 km. Both have to cover 600 km to reach Thiruvananthapuram. So in all the cases, distance is 600 km. So first we will find the time taken by Ramu to reach Thiruvananthapuram. Time is equal to distance by speed. While substituting, we can write 600 by 120, that is equal to 5 hours. So to reach Thiruvananthapuram, Ramu take 5 hours. In return journey, how much it take? Time is equal to distance by speed. While substituting, we get 600 by 50 km per hour, that is equal to 12 hours. So return journey, while returning, Ramu take 12 hours to reach back. Now coming to the case of Selim, to reach the same place, they start the journey from the same place. So distance remains same for both, 600 km itself. So here time taken is equal to distance by speed. While substituting, we get 600 by 60, that is equal to 10 hours. And for return journey also, speed is same. So time is equal to distance by speed, that is equal to 600 by 60. Here also, the Selim take the same time to cover back. Now, to see who has taken less time, we will calculate the time taken by Ramu as well as by Selim. Total time is equal to 5 plus 12. 5 plus 12 is equal to 17 hours. So Ramu takes 17 hours first to complete the journey. And total time taken by Selim is 10 plus 10. That is 20 hours. So Selim take 20 hours to complete the journey. So who take less time? Ramu traveled in less time. Ramu take less time to complete the journey.
Next question. Two trains traveling along parallel tracks in the same direction do 50 km per hour and 100 km per hour on average. The faster train starts 2 hours later than the slower. After how many kilometers will the faster train catch up?
According to the question, two trains traveling along parallel tracks. Two trains are traveling along parallel tracks in the same direction. Do 50 km per hour and 100 km per hour. First train travel 50 km in 1 hour and the second train travel 100 km in 1 hour. The faster train starts 2 hours later than the slower train. So this train starts 2 hours later than the slower train. Now, after how many kilometer will the faster train will catch up? That means after how many kilometer the second train, the faster train will reach along with the slower train. Average speed of the faster train is 50 kilometer per hour and average speed of the second train is 100 kilometer per hour. That means for the first train, for the first 1 hour, it reached 50 km. Second hour, it will reach 100 km. Third hour, it will reach 150 km and so on. And according to the second train, for the first hour, it will reach 100 km. For the second hour, it will reach 200 km. And for the third hour, it will reach 300 km. So we can write, in 1 hour, it cover 50 km. In second hour, it will cover 100 km. And third hour, it will cover 150 km. And it will go on like that. Okay. And according to the second train, in 1 hour, it cover 100 km. In second hour, it will cover 200 km. In third hour, it will cover 300 km. And so on. So, we have to see when this faster train catch up with the first train.
Now look here, when the first train starts the journey,
in first hour reaches 50 km, in second hour reaches 100 km. So in after 2 hour, the second train will start the journey. Okay, third hour, the slower train reaches 150 km and faster train reaches 100 km. For the fourth hour, the slower train reaches 200 km and faster train reaches 200 km. So we can write faster train catch up with the slower train after 200 km. Okay?
Next question. A 125 meter long train travels 90 km per hour. How much time would it take to cross a 175 meter long bridge?
According to the question, a 125 meter long train travels 90 km per hour. That is, length of the train is 125 meter and average speed of the train is 90 km per hour. How much time it would take to cross 175 meter long bridge? Length of the bridge is 175 meter. So length of the train 125 meter and length of the bridge is 175 meter. How much time it take to cover this much area? That means distance is what? 125 plus 175. So we can write distance is equal to 125 meter plus 175 meter. That is equal to 300 meter. Distance is 300 meter and average speed is 90 kilometer per hour. Now we can find the time. But see children, here speed is given in kilometer per hour and distance is given as meter. So first of all, we have to convert this into meter per second. To convert this into meter per second, we know 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter. So 90 kilometer we can write it as 90 into 1000 meter. By hour we can convert into second. 1 hour is equal to 60 into 60 second. So here to convert this into hour, we write 60 into 60 second. While calculating, we get the answer 25 meter per second. So average speed is 25 meter per second. Now we can calculate the time taken. Time taken is equal to distance by speed. That is equal to 300 meter by 25 meter per second. When we divide, we get 12 seconds. So time taken to cover the bridge of 175 meter is 12 seconds.